Psalm chapter 13 and verse 5, it is written, "But I trust in your unfailing love. I will rejoice because you have rescued me." Now, what I'm about to say isn't founded on data from research that I've conducted or have recently become aware of. But for many of us, 2020 has been a year full of things that appear to have gone wrong. With each passing month, it feels like our lives become more and more out of control. And to compound our angst, it seems like God has been slow to act on our behalf when the going has gotten tough. What are we to do when the weight from life's difficulties become too overbearing? And while our inclination would be to do what comes naturally, which is to complain or to become impatient and embrace a pessimistic attitude and perspective, I believe we must be willing to respond in a supernatural way. From David's response to his calamity in Psalm chapter 13, we learn of two supernatural responses that can help lift us above our circumstances. See, despite our condition and emotion, it's critical that we take a moment to affirm our trust in the Lord and to express to Him gratitude for our rescue. See, trusting and thanking may seem like unnatural and irrational things to do given the state that we're in. When you're going through so much, it doesn't seem normal or natural to be in a position to be hopeful or to be thankful. But the Word of God declares that when we exercise these things, we activate the advocacy of the Father. When we trust Him, the book of Proverbs says that He will make our path straight. When we trust Him, the book of Proverbs also says that He will keep us safe. In Psalms, it says that when we trust God, He will act on our behalf. Jeremiah says that He will bless us. And then in Isaiah, the prophet declares that when we trust the Father, He will provide us with a perfect peace. And when we thank Him, when we give God praise, He will be glorified. When we thank God and bless His name, we'll know that we're accomplishing His will for our lives. When we thank God, our faith in Him will be deepened. When we thank God, we'll receive aid to live in the present. We'll be able to find contentment and draw closer to the One who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ask or think. We can't allow the misery of our moment to restrict our responses to only what's natural and rational. I want to encourage you today to defy what feels normal and makes sense. Reaffirm your trust in God, even though it seems like His response to your plea is stuck in delay. Express gratitude to the Lord, even though situations of loss and struggle have pierced your heart to the core. These kind of expressions, I understand, aren't always easy to reflect when life's turned upside down. And you may be in a place today where it's hard to do these things. I feel you. But it's in these defining moments that God will meet us right where we are and equip us with exactly what we need to persist. God wants us to persist despite the trials, despite the storms. He has given us enough to make it. All that's required of us is to continue to believe that He will come through. And in addition to believing and trusting in Him, we need to continually give Him praise. So have faith today, friends, and give God praise, because He truly will cause all things to work together for our good, because we love Him and we're called according to his purpose. Let's pray. Father, thank you so much for this tremendous reminder that despite the condition we're in or the circumstances that we're facing, you, God, can still act in the midst of those things. Father, if we would continue to just exercise an unyielding faith and trust in you and be willing to express gratitude despite what's going on in our lives, that Father, you are able to just do amazing things in our lives. Father, help us not to kind of read or gauge your faithfulness in our lives based on the trauma that we're dealing with or the struggles that we're in. But Father, it's in those moments that we ask that you will remind us of the promises in your word. Promises that remind us of what happens when we exercise unyielding trust in you and an ability to thank you despite our condition. Father, your word proves itself to be true. You will come and act and move on our behalf. So Father, wherever my friends are in their lives, would you bless them today? Would you keep them safe and protected? And may they continue to seek your truth that's embedded in your word. We ask this in the name of Jesus. Thank God and amen. May the Lord bless and keep you today.